gonna show you guys like 30 seconds. Great. Have you ever sparred kilo? What's that like? What makes him?
We must have sparred like 100 rounds in this past month.
What makes him good as a fighter?
Like, just grit. You know what I mean? He goes hard. He's smart. But also got balls too. So
12-2 with 8 knockouts.
Yeah. He's on his way up.
Oof, that was a big punch. This gym has very good sparring.
Yeah, I really like this gym. Cool. Everybody about business, huh?
That's Pita, everybody. You can follow him at _GarciaPita. Especially, I recommend follow him on Twitter as well, not only Instagram, if you want to be entertained.
Same thing.
It's the same thing. There's a 1:30. It's very top-notch sparring over here. You have Chepe working with Brian Lua. Putting a work, another minute or so left on the ground. Your next Ken, how many rounds are they going?
We're gonna go 2 and I'm gonna go 2. I think me and Philo are gonna go 2 after that. So.
Okay. It's round 1, but it's such so it's more entertaining than some TV fights that we've seen. They're letting their hands
roll. Yeah, Kilo likes to start really fast. So.
That's good. Good. It's all about the cardio too.
Yeah, hell yeah.
I don't like running, personally. Yeah, I have basketball, soccer, running. Some people love it. I see you. Running. You running with? Do you run with your dog?
Yeah, sometimes.
I see that on the Instagram.
Hey, but he sometimes he's pulling me, and I'm just taking away from my workout. So I'm like, I just need to go by myself, my headphones.
Yeah. All right. Round 1 in the book. They hit after the bell. Who gets disqualified?
Probably you.
You disqualified. You hit after the bell. Do you need water, Kilo? Chepe to the rescue.
He's been in his corner,
huh?
Supposed to be working his corner.
I was supposed to work his corner. That's true. I've been good, just very, very busy with everything.
Yeah.
And I'm excited that boxing's coming back.
Yeah, me too. I think we're gonna go to Mexico. Hopefully, get some fights.
That'd be sick.
When do you think they're opening up?
I think June. We're starting June 9 and June 11, and then.
You're in California or?
No, Nevada.
Oh, okay.
And July, we're gonna start seeing a lot of fights. August, September. So coming up next few months.
Yeah.
Genaro Gamas and amateurs was number 1 in the world, and decided to turn pro instead of going to the Olympics in San Diego, California. His dad is here with him today. What's up, Australia? What time is it? 6 in the morning. I have that out. These guys are tomorrow right here. Hector Tanahara is an athlete. He's getting all the sports. Soccer, baseball, badminton, tennis, golf. He does it all. And boxing.
I could have made it to NBA.
You should have tried. Would you play for the Spurs if you could?
Yeah.
Tell everybody where to follow you.
Follow me at Hector Leonardo. ECTORLEO.
6-0. Reminds me of Chino Maidana. He's a hard hitter. Fights at 140 and he looks You're not weighing 140 right now, right?
No, right now.
You're a little more.
I'm probably like, I don't know, 20 pounds over my weight.
That's normal.
Yeah. Well, follow me at Hector Leonardo. Sign?
I missed it.
That's no sir.
It's okay? It's good?
Dude, you can't hear
it. Josecito, Victor Ortiz was live this week, and he was talking to Jose Vargas. Did you see that?
No.
He said the one fight he wants a rematch with you.
Oh,
what do you think about you and him in a rematch?
I didn't know he was still fighting.
No, he's fighting. He started your training this week.
Yeah, I'm down to fight him.
You're down for a rematch?
That'd be a good fight. The first one was good, too. So, that'd be a good fight.
If you get the call, do you want to fight Victor Ortiz? The answer would be yes.
I'm looking for a big fight, so I don't know. I don't know if that'd be next, but I'm down to fight him. Nobody's scared.
You like that fight, him and Victor Ortiz?
Yeah, it's in the fridge.
That's a good one. Do you have any fight date or any opponent?
No, nothing yet, but...
You're staying ready.
All the way.
Did you start sparring yet or not yet?
No.
Okay, so you're just waiting to get that call.
Yep.
Do you see what Adrian Broner said?
What is it?
10 million on becoming a full-time rapper.
That's crazy. Well, what do you mean 10 million on being a
He wants to get paid 10 million a box.
I mean, I'm sure he's made more than that already, now.
Yeah, he's made more.
Who?
Adrian, when he fought Pacquiao, I'm sure he got more than 10.
Yeah, I'm sure he got paid more than 10.
It'll be interesting to see.
It would. You can be a full-time boxer and quit rapping.
Yeah, Big G in the house today. Joel Diaz Jr. What's up, Hector? How you feeling?
Good, man. Chilling. Just getting ready, staying ready for whatever.
135 division is deep. One or two more wins and you're in the mix with the elite of the elite.
Yes, sir. It's coming.
They already talked. There were talks of you fighting Devin Haney, talks of you fighting Ryan Garcia.
Those are the fights we're looking for, we would like. Hopefully it happens soon.
Boy, you're 19-0. You're practically there.
Yeah. You see the fights, too.
And now, look, a lot of fighters at the gym already have dates.
Yeah, we're staying ready.
He's ready in your fight shape.
Yeah. Are you in shot? What are you weighing right now? 43? 44?
Like 45.
It's pretty good.
That's good.
So you're 10 pounds away. That's great. You could lose that in one day if you needed to.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, @Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, @Elie Seckbach.